From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Karkos. A new poll showing Democratic gubernatorial candidate Libby Mitchell is making up ground on Republican candidate Paula Page.
According to Rasmussen reports in a statewide telephone survey of likely voters, 35% now say they plan to vote for LePage, with 32% saying they support Mitchell. Now, with the margin of error, it is basically a dead heat at this point. Just a month ago, LePage had a nearly 20% lead. Independent Elliot Cutler drawing his highest support yet, polling at 21%. Now, 6% say they prefer another candidate. 6% are still undecided.
The Augusta Board of Education voting unanimously to separate boys and girls taking remedial math at Coney High School. The idea of the single gender course all came about when educators noticed a large discrepancy between boys' and girls' SAT scores last year. 46% of girls did not meet the standards for math scores. That's far more than the boys. The student liaison to the school board says he thinks students will need time to get used to the idea.
The students probably at first is going to be that hard time of they'll probably won't understand what's going on, but in the long run, I think this could be very effective.
Math strategies will only be taught at Coney High School on an as-needed basis, not necessarily every year. This year's SAT scores did not show as much of a gap between boys and girls in math, but teachers want the option to implement the class going forward if they see the large discrepancy in the scores again. Today, the cruise ship Celebrity Summit will be pulling into Portland. It carries 1,900 passengers along with it, who will spread out across the southern part of the state, hopefully to give our local economy another boost. It's one of several ships spending time here in Portland this week. On Monday, the Carnival Glory brought more than 2,700 tourists here to Maine. And on this Saturday, the largest ship of the week, the Explorer of the Seas, will bring more than 3,000 passengers right here to Portland.
A very special auction in Portland helping to provide services to more than 600 teens and young adults with developmental disabilities. Last night, the sixth annual auction for Strive was held at the Ocean Gateway Terminal in Portland. There's some big things available, like a McDreamy package, including an autographed picture of Patrick Dempsey from Grey's Anatomy and a set of scrubs. This is one of the group's biggest fundraisers of the year. Organizers say they'll have a final number later today, but it looks like they raised between $35,000 and $40,000. After years of work and more than $1.5 million, the State Theater in downtown Portland will open again tomorrow. Landlords stabilized the balcony, installed a new ceiling, added fire escapes and a new electrical system. The new tenants who will run the business and manage the show spent a lot of money on cosmetics. They built two new bars, added new flooring, new seats, and they raised the stage 21 inches.
It's really to increase the sight lines in the whole venue. They weren't ever really bad, but since we have the flexibility of fully seating the venue and then taking up the chairs up front and having a GA pit, an open pit, we wanted people to be able to sit in the back and still see the artists when people are standing up front.
The first show is tomorrow night featuring the band My Morning Jacket. It is already sold out.
Looks good.
It looks great.
Fantastic. Good for them. That's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We'll bring the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.